right, now we're with Absolution Brewing. We have Oz. You're one of the brewers?
No, just assisting.
You're Oz? What's your name?
Oz.
I'm Hans. Good to meet you.
We're going to back that off a little bit because we're spiking.
Oh, okay. Oh, I see.
It actually picks up really
well. Oh, wow, you're right. I see it. Okay.
It's really good, right? Okay.
Well, where am I looking at?
Oh, yeah, it's not.
Doesn't matter.
Backwards. Okay, so we have two beers from Absolution Brewing. Absolution is our neighbor. You guys are really close. Like a mile and a half from us.
If that, yeah. Yeah, just about.
Yeah, so we can walk there, get wasted, walk back, whatever.
Right. Why is
That's
it?
How we
it's
do
a little bit.
Torrance.
It's a little bit. I mean, it's like a mile, couple miles. It's like a mile walk. But it's no big deal.
You know.
Especially when you're drunk. It's cool.
Exactly. No. It might take you a
one could walk there.
Yeah, or a bike. A bike.
Right. A bike. A bike.
Okay, so we have two. We have the Mad Monk, which is a stout, right?
No, this one is a brown. American brown.
American brown. American brown.
Oh, this is the one we were talking about.
That
the
is
one.
Really
yeah, a little
dark
darker,
brown.
Right? Nice
wow,
solid
yeah,
brown color of food.
And then this is the Wicked IPA.
This is the Wicked. So just by the name, you can tell it's a little bit on the heavier side.
Uh-huh.
That is one of our heavy hitters.
Okay, I think we should go with this
first.
One first after the empanadas.
Okay.
Because with
oh,
the chili,
okay. So I see.
That's
okay,
going to pair better.
Okay, ladies first, though. You give it, okay, you give it a drink.
And so then Wicked IPA. Anything special about this IPA?
Oh, let's see. It's almost at a 10%er. 9.6.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a little malty. A little maltier than most double IPAs are going to be.
I like the malts. Yeah. It's not a fruity IPA.
No, it's not a beginner beer.
Not a beginner beer?
Not a beginner.
Well, I like it.
I mean, I guess it's
not like that I'm a beginner beer drinker.
It's got a pretty, it clean, it finishes pretty clean, but then there's a little bit of residual like bitterness from the hops
right
on the back of your
yes
tongue. I like beers that kind of have a little bit of flavor profile
weight,
that kind of surprises
right
you at the
it
end.
Yeah,
I
that
like
was
it.
10%. Uh-huh.
Oh wow, that's 10. I'm surprised. We've had a lot of beers today that have been like pretty strong beers, pretty big beers, but yet the flavor has actually been pretty mellow. It must be in the way that they brew it, man.
Yeah, I think so. With the IPAs too, having it fresh is gonna make a big difference.
Yes, you have to have it fresh to enjoy the
yeah
get the best out of it.
Yeah, that pairs really nice with the empanada shop.
So you guys are one of our newest brewers in the South Bay. Absolutely, you guys are less than a year old, if I'm not mistaken,
just
right?
Hit her
just
year
just
in
hit
March.
Her 1 year. Okay, cool.
Just hit her 1 year.
Now we're gonna try the Mad Monk,
okay,
which is a nut brown ale. I can't believe that. This is so dark.
It looks a lot darker than it really is.
Wow.
It's our newest beer. Okay, let's
see.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
newest beer. Newest beer. But still, it tastes lighter than it looks.
Oh.
It smells like chocolate caramel.
Yes, yeah, so there's caramel in there.
Yeah, it smells like those Rolos, you know, like the chocolate with the caramel.
I love Rolos.
Forever.
That's
a good way to describe
like
it, though. That's a good way to describe it.
And then, but the taste was really mellow. Both of these are really mellow.
You're dead on with the Rolos, because there's a caramel in there, too.
Yes.
I taste, oh, and it does the same thing where it sneaks up on the back end. It kind of starts clean, and then there's a little bit of bitterness on the back, which I like.
I mean, that's not too bitter to me at all. I think that's really good.
No, it's just like that little bit of like, oh, I had a beer at the end, you know?
But, I mean, this looks like it would be a heavy beer, but and this
one's
a lower. This is only 5.2%. So this you could definitely have with a meal, and it's not going to...
Speaking of meals with that, we collaborated with Big Cup Soup.
Oh, right!
So their cheddar soup, they add some of the soup in there, and it just, you can taste it.
Wow, I have to try that. I haven't scheduled with them. We need to bring them up and try some Big Cup soup with the Mad Monk. Oh, man.
So we flip-flop these two. Should I go get some people? Let them know?
We'll let them. I think especially the brewers are a little overwhelmed.
Oh, okay.
Have a little bit of extra time, we can make up for it.
Okay,
there.
Cool.
So we'll be okay.
Maybe you should put some soup in there.
No, that would ruin my beer.
No, I'm saying, put some soup in the slot. And then put the beer in the soup. I was just thinking it'd be great if you guys were back to back. Wait, did you bring the beer? Are they using the beer that you guys brought here as your samples? Or they made it from something else?
Oh.
Do they make it from something different?
They came.
No, no, I mean, yeah, it's what we serve at the brewery.
Like, I mean, it's neither of these, though, is it? Or what is the beer they use? With this one, with that one? Oh, okay, cool. I mean, that's what I was saying. If you were back-to-back, it would be good to be like, oh, I taste the Mad Monkey, just because you're kind of like prime for it.
Oh, yeah.
We, I just have to remember Rolos. I'm just like, I can taste
that's
the Rolos.
That's what
I'm
going to use now.
It's totally Rolos. I used to eat those all the time when I was a kid. You know, they're shaped kind of like little corks.
Right, little
corks. So you put it in the top of a root beer bottle, and then you shake it up, and then you put it in your mouth, and it would pop the cork into the back of your mouth. It's very dangerous.
That is genius.
Super fun when I was a kid.
You know what? I bet there's going to be, like, internet sensation. It's going to be, like, people all over.
No.
Do the Rolo challenge. Oh, my God.
The Rolo challenge. That's right. Kidding.
Try it at home.
No, I don't think there's enough pressure behind it to get it all the way down your throat.
No, I really don't think so.
We'll find out in about a week.
Yep, once it goes viral, well, then they'll know.
Oh, awesome. Oz, if you want, you're welcome to stick around with us, or if you want to get back to the table, that's good too. We're going to have Spread the Love Peanut Butter in Smog City coming up.
Smog City, oh yeah. The neighbors. We'll get back to you right over there.
All right, cool. Thank you. Cool.
We'll see you over there.
Good to meet you. Thanks so much. And that's awesome that you guys hooked it up with Big Cup Soup. I mean, what a cool event to be able to do that, to be able to really integrate the flavors of Los Angeles.
Yeah. And I noticed a lot of beers are doing that. Uh-huh. Hot sauces and jams. But in soup, this is the first time that I've done that soup, and it's like... Yeah.
We're hoping... I mean, this is our first year at the event. It's good turnout. Hopefully, it won't be our last. I mean, it looks like it's pretty good.
By the way,
what I'm hoping is, like, maybe in future years, we really might get to the point. Hopefully, people are meeting and mingling, and maybe they'll naturally come together. That next year, they'll be like, our booth was right next to theirs. We found this great combination of having our jam right after their IPA, and it was amazing.
Exactly.
So, and then they'll make some great concoctions like you guys made. I'm looking forward
for
to
that.
It.
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. Thanks so much for coming out, man.
Thank you. Thanks again.
Thank you.
All right, guys.